Okay, we are able to show that it's going to be reflexive, symmetric and transitive, but the second part at the end of, see, from problem number 9 onwards, at the end of the problem, every time a second part of the problem will be mentioned. After discussing relation, something else also will be mentioned. In this example, what is that they are telling? What are the elements related to 1? See, in this example, any element related to 1 should satisfy this condition. Only 1 equal to 1. Correct, right? You cannot say 1 equal to 2, 1 equal to 3, 1 equal to 4. Only possible condition is going to be 1 equal to 1. Therefore, the elements related to 1 is just going to be 1. Okay, that's how the conclusion should be written. Now, the next problem number 10. We have problem number 10 and they said that give an example of the following relation. Surely in the final examination, one of those problems, most of the time they will be asked for 1 mark. Whatever, how much ever I am going to explain, it's just my examples which I created. Until unless you sit and you practice and start creating your own example, sorry, you cannot memorize and carry on to the examination. So my suggestion, try to create an example wherever it's possible. So in the 10th one, I will just explain only one problem out of this. The rest, yes, I will do it and leave it for you. You give a practice. Okay, fine. They said that give an example for the first one. The relation should be symmetric, but it should not be reflexive, but and it should not be transitive. I'll just show you how to do it for one example. The rest you please try it. Okay, fine. The most important thing, whenever you want to create an example, you have to start with a set. Let's consider A is equal to 1, 2, 3. I will take one set. On this set, I have to write an example. That means I have to write the elements for the relation. The relation has to be symmetric. If you know, actually, if I start with 1, 2, if it has to be symmetric, the next element has to be 2, 1. If you want, close it here itself. It doesn't make a difference. Why? Whatever the condition I needed, it's already satisfied. Symmetric, 1, 2 is there, 2, 1 is there. It is going to be symmetric. It is certainly not reflexive because 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. None of them are present. And if it is not at all transitive, because transitive discussion is possible, you have 1 comma 2 and you have 2 comma 1. If suppose this has to be transitive, then 1 comma 1 should be present by eliminating these two. It's not there, right? Hence it cannot be transitive. Not just this, you have 1 comma 2, you have 2 comma 1. You can include 2 comma 3 also, or you can include any of additional elements. If you're writing it also is fine. If you're not going to write, then also it's fine. That's an additional element for me. Okay, let us check for all. Symmetric, yes, it's fine. Okay, 1 comma 2 is there, 2 comma 1 is there. Now take one element and reverse, you get this. Now if I take this element and reverse, still I get the same. It is symmetric. Is it reflexive? No, only 2 2 is there, 1 1 3 3 is not there. Is it transitive? So one thing is, you can go for the discussion of these two. That's enough actually. Okay, I can just go with these two. But if I discuss these two, 1 comma 2 and 2 comma 2, by eliminating this, still I'm going to get 1 comma 2, which is all. You don't take the example where it's possible. You take an example where it's not possible. That's how the way it should be done. Got it? Okay. Now, see students, that's how the example should be created. Whatever the examples I create, they are my ideas. Okay, they are my things. Actually, you have to sit and you have to start practicing your own examples. So the most important thing, okay, write a set, then start the discussion. Okay, now let's move to the next problem number 11. Problem number 11 is based on a set actually. The set is set of all points on a plane. Okay, there are so many points, so set of all points on a plane. On this, a relation will contain, see, what are P and Q? P and Q are any two points, but you cannot consider any two points in a relation. Now P and Q are any two points such that distance of P and Q from origin is same. From origin is same. Now that type of two points will be taken as one ordered pair in the given relation. See, on a plane there can be n number of points. Okay, and from the origin, okay, let me take this as P and Q. Measure the distance. If the distance of OP, if I am able to find OP is equal to OQ, then you say that this is one ordered pair which exists in the given relation. Okay, now let me take it as R here. Now, here you certainly notice OP is not equal to OR. Distance from origin to this point, distance from origin to this point are not same. Then OR, okay, PR does not exist in the given relation. Two points will be one ordered pair, okay, only if the distance of those two points from the origin is same. This is the explanation what you needed. Okay, now that is just to make you understand the problem. That's it. Now let us continue for reflexive. For all A belongs to the given set, every time you have to start the discussion from any element of the given set. For all A belongs to the given set, now can I say that A and A have same distance from origin? It's possible. Point and the point itself, you are repeating it, right? So this says that an ordered pair A comma A exists in the given relation. Now the next, for symmetric. So what is symmetric? Let me start with A comma B belongs to R. According to the given relation, A and B have same distance from origin. If A and B have same distance from origin, it also says that B and A also have same distance from origin. So if B and A have same distance from origin, ordered pair B comma A belongs to R. Hence R is going to be symmetric. Now the next thing, for transitive, let me consider A comma B and B comma C belongs to R. See, in all these examples you should know how to begin, how to end it. That is most important. Now according to this, A and B have same distance from origin. Statements, so I'm not writing it very clearly. Okay, and the next one is B and C have same distance from origin. So that means there are three points. What is this will actually give me? There are three points. What are the three points? A, B, C, and all the three have same distance from origin. So this says that even A and C also have same distance from origin. Now in such case, ordered pair A comma C belongs to R. Hence R is going to be transitive. Okay, so it's reflexive, it is symmetric, and also it's going to be transitive. Now in the same thing, they mentioned something there at the end of the problem. Now show that the set of all points which are related to P is a circle passing through origin. I will explain with the diagram. This is P here, right? So let me join here. So this is Q, let me join. So if I say that P comma Q belongs to R, OP should be equal to OQ. So let me take one more point here. Now let me take it as X. I will measure the distance, and even OP is equal to OX. So let me take one point Y here, then OP is equal to OY. I will take such kind of points where whatever the relation is given is true. Whenever I join these points, actually what is that I'm going to get? Certainly the distance of any point from the origin will be same every time, right? So in such case, all the points when I join which are related to P, now those points when I join, I'm going to get a circle. This is what the second part of the problem. Fine students, now let's move on to the next one. The next one is problem number 12. We have another three problems to discuss, so let us try to finish these three problems in today's session. The last two are MCQs, you can manage those. So let me start with problem number 12. Problem number 12 is based on set of all triangles on this relation R is defined as R contains ordered pair T1 and T2 such that T1 is similar to T2. You should know the meaning of similar, that's it, right? It's an easy thing. I have to show it's an equivalence relation. So certainly for reflexive, for all T1 belongs to the given set, a triangle T1 is similar to T1. A triangle is similar to itself. Right. Now this says that the ordered pair T1, T1 belongs to the given relation. That is how reflexive should be checked. Now to check for symmetric, quite simple. If I say T1 is similar to T2, it's obviously say T2 is similar to T1. It's obvious. So therefore ordered pair T2, T1 belongs to R, hence it's going to be symmetric. The next, transitive. Now clearly, now if I take T1 is similar to T2 and T2 is similar to T3, certainly T1 is similar to T3. T1 is similar to T2, T2 is similar to T3, that means T1, T2, T3, all the three triangles are similar, therefore T1 will be similar to T3, hence R is going to be transitive. Fine. If it is reflexive, symmetric, transitive, hence the given relation is going to be an equivalence relation. Now, at the end of that, again, every time something will be given in a to conclude, something else will be given, right? There is a triangle T1. T1 is having 3, 4, 5, right? And the next is going to be T2. T2 is having the sides 5, 12, 13. And T3 are having the sides 6, 8, 10. What are the similar triangles? When I take the ratios of the corresponding side, all the three ratios should be same. So the what they are asking is, what are, at the end of the problem, they said that which among the three triangles are related. So I want to check out of T1, T2, T3. These are the sides which are being mentioned to us. Out of these three, which two are similar? Quite simple. Now just observe the ratio of T1 and T2. I will take the ratio of T1 and T2, 3 by 5, 4 by 12, 5 by 13. And then I will take the ratio of T1 and T3, 3 by 6, let's take the ratio, that's it, 3 by 6, 4 by 8 and 5 by 10. Can be written as 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. That's all the condition of similar triangles will be taken. Take the ratios of the corresponding side and all the three ratios should be same. So notice here, all these three ratios are equal. Hence, I will say that these two are going to be related in this example. Now, let's go to the next problem number 13. Problem number 13 is based on A is set of all polygons. On this, a relation R will contains P1 and P2 such that P1 and P2 have same number of sides. Second part I will come to later. Now, how to discuss this for reflexive? Quite simple. For all, P1 belongs to the given set. What is the set here? A. Can I write that P1 and T1 have same number of sides? That means if P1 is a triangle, P1, when I repeat, again it's going to be a triangle only, right? So P1, P2 have same number of sides. You cannot take P1 as triangle and P2 as a square. If P1 is a triangle, P2 also should be a triangle only. Now, it is possible to write P1 and P2 have same number of sides. Therefore, ordered pair P1, P1 belongs to R. Hence, R is going to be reflexive. Second, for symmetric, let me start with P1, P2 belongs to R. This says that P1 and P2 have same number of sides. I can also write P2 and P1 also have same number of sides. It doesn't make any difference. Therefore, ordered pair P2, P1 belongs to R. Hence, R is going to be symmetric. Next, I want to check for transitive. So, if I want to check for transitive, Let me start with P1, P2 and P2, P3 belongs to R. P1, P2 have same number of sides. P2, P3 have same number of sides. Certainly P1 and P3 have same number of sides. Hence R is going to be transitive. You have to observe the procedure remains the same. Only the thing is the set is changed, the elements are changed, that's it. Okay. In this also the second part is given as which is if there is a triangle which has been mentioned, the side are 3, 4, 5. What are the elements of the given set which are related to T? What is T here? Triangle. What are the elements related to triangle in this example? Of course, what is the set of all triangles? Don't think anything else. It is something like this is T1. What are the elements related to T1? Any polygon which is having three sides. So what we call any polygon is having three sides? Triangle. Okay, so if this is a triangle, what has been given to us, the elements which are related to this element are going to be set of all triangles. Don't think, sir, this is a right angle triangle, only right angle triangle will be related to this. No, it's a triangle, so every triangle is related to this only. Fine. Now let's move on to the next problem number 14. In problem number 14, the set is L, set of all lines in a plane, and on this a relation R contains ordered pair x, sorry, L1, L2 such that L1 is parallel to L2. Right? So we have to show this relation is going to be equivalence relation. First, for reflexive, for all, L1 belongs to L. They have mentioned L as the given set. Fine, okay. Now, can I write L1 is parallel to L1? If this is the line L1, okay, if this is the line L1, of course it is parallel to itself. Every line is parallel to itself. Therefore, ordered pair L1, L1 belongs to R. Hence, R is going to be reflexive. Now, to check for symmetric, the symmetric condition starts L1, L2 belongs to R. That means L1 is parallel to L2. You can just notice here, if L1 is parallel to L2, L2 is also parallel to L1. Therefore, L2 is parallel. L2 is parallel to L1. Hence, ordered pair L2, L1 belongs to R. Therefore, R is going to be, hence R is going to be symmetric. Now, the next to check for transitive. To check for transitive, I have to start L1, L2 and L2, L3 belongs to R. L1, L2, L3. This says L1 parallel to L2, L2 parallel to L3. You notice here, even these two are also parallel. Therefore, L1 parallel to L3. Hence, ordered pair L1, L3 belongs to R. So, that means the given relation is transitive. It's reflexive, symmetric, transitive. Hence, it's going to be an equivalence relation. The second part in this. What are the lines which are related to y is equal to 2x plus 4? What are the elements which are, what are the lines? This is a line actually. What are the lines related to this actually? This, let me write it as 2x minus 5 plus 4 equal to 0. If you remember in first year straight line, ax plus by plus c equal to 0. It is a standard straight line equation. Any line parallel to this will be ax plus by plus k. Only the constant will be changed. Now here also, because see, in this example, a line is related to another line if they are parallel. This is one line. What are the family of lines parallel to this? Family of lines parallel to this will be 2x minus y plus k equal to 0. That's all we have to mention. Fine students, now we come to the end of this session. I said the last two problems, 15 and 16, they're MCQs, you can manage. They are not at all difficult. Okay. The only thing is, we have done so much, we have finished the first exercise already. So please sit back, just practice, go through once or twice. If not, please call back to us. If you don't have my number, you have my number on WhatsApp group already. If not, please call up or WhatsApp, okay, on this number. I will clarify your doubts. Not just to me, any of the mass lecturers from EduStrain, you can contact and you can get clarified your doubt. So sit back, practice. Let's meet in the next class. Thank you.